Talking about sex is no different than talking about anything else, no matter how much we want it to be. Sex education is something that must be taken seriously in schools, and not just be a throw-aside program that schools can get rid of because of budget cuts, religious, or moral reasons. If every school in the world had sex education all year round, our world would be a healthier and safer place. Sex education is a vital part of society. It is proven that if sex ed is taught to kids under the age of 10, it not only teaches them about their own emotional and physiological changes, but it also encourages better behavior and better habits towards themselves and the opposite sex. According to the NCSL, National Conference of State Legislators, there are currently 24 states in the US that do not require their school districts to teach sex education. And the very few schools that are teaching sex education are preaching abstinence.
A small high school in West Texas that does not offer sex education is dealing with an STD outbreak.
A significant rise in STDs among Utah teens.
Parents can always preach abstinence, but teens, we know, don't always listen.
A chlamydia outbreak.
Chlamydia.
Chlamydia.
Why does Texas continue with abstinence education programs when they don't seem to be working? In fact, I think we have the third highest teen pregnancy rate in the country among all the states.
Abstinence works.
But we are the third highest teen pregnancy. We have the third highest teen pregnancy rate among all states in the country. The questioner's point is, it doesn't seem to be working.
I'm going to tell you from my own personal life, abstinence works.
Abstinence is one of the biggest reasons for America's ever-growing teen pregnancy rate. According to the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, America's teen pregnancy rate is the highest in the developed world. When abstinence is taught, contraception is not covered. Because why should it be if you're teaching abstinence, right? Without this important information, teens are left to learn about contraception and sexual intercourse all alone, or from unreliable sources. Imagine the cost to any country for this lack of education. Teenage pregnancies, female circumcision, the consequence of rape against women and men, and the nature of homophobia are just some of the problems that countries will face without sex education. I was lucky enough to be in grade school when Eve Ensler came to present her global project for V-Day. She is a sex education and women's rights activist and author of the Vagina Monologues. I was able to be in contact with her, and she let me know that she's a strong believer that when a man is educated, it limits their chances of committing violence against women. So, as we enter a new technological age, the governments and schools around the world need to check and see how their programs are doing with the technology side of things. Social media, something we all love and use daily. Let's now focus on how technology should be a new point of focus for sex education classes. Kids are now exposed to electronics at increasingly younger ages. According to Make Love Not Porn founder Cindy Gallup, kids as young as 6 have been able to access hardcore porn. This is extremely destructive for a society because this is fantasy that can be very addictive, which can limit sex drive in the future, as well as demean and portray women as objects of male gratification, which does nothing to forward the equality of the sexes. Upon my arrival at Green School, I was astounded to see that this school did not have any sex education until 9th grade. This made me worry about kids not being taught about their bodies and what's to come. All my life, I've had parents that have talked to me very openly about the different aspects of sex education, love, addiction, and growth. I'm also very privileged to have 3 older sisters who never edited their conversations because I was around. This was extremely beneficial for me, because when I started being taught sex education in Italy at the tender age of 6, I was able to unashamedly immerse myself in the class and listen. Sex education is a tricky subject to talk about, especially to fifth graders, as I have learned. Other than puberty, which me and my classmates are having a blast going through, fifth graders, who are on the brink of being preteens and experiencing puberty themselves, have a pretty hard time learning about all the creepy things they'll be going through. I was fortunate enough to visit several fifth grade growth classes and observe the language and how students receive this information. I learned what is necessary and important to create my own program. From this, I have created a workshop, although it will need some refining to be used in other schools. So, there is a lot for me to still learn about the future of my project. There's a lot for me to still learn about sex education. So, for the future of my project, I want to continue advocating sex education in all schools, starting in primary. And my project will start here in Bali. Bali's sex education program is next to nothing. I spoke to several of my Balinese teachers, and they told me that when they were growing up, they had one man that came every 6 months to talk about sex with them. Talk about them with sex. Finally, I'd like to thank all my teachers for helping me along this project and my parents for inspiring me. So, now that I've told you all the implications of not having sex education in schools, I want you to take one thing away with you. I am a 13-year-old boy at the height of my awkwardness. If I can stand up here in front of you and say words like sex, porn, and chlamydia, I'm sure you can too. Talk to each other, discuss your worries and your feelings, and always share knowledge. Yeah. Woo!